In this lecture, we are going to talk about model evaluation and improvement. We have deeply, in this lecture, we will dive deeply into the evaluation models and selecting the parameters. To evaluate our supervised models, so far we have used the method of separating our data set into training and test subject function, training set and test set, using the train test subject function. Built a and then we built a model and fit the model and then evaluate the model on the test set and using score methods, which for classification computes the fraction of correctly classified samples. Here is an example of that process. We take a data set, we take a data from the sklearn data set, we take the blobs as a points, and then we take the linear regression model as a model, and then we take the function as train test subject. We create a synthetic data set using the make blobs, and then subject this data set into training and test set, and fit the and logistic regression for the training set to come up with a model. And we evaluate this model on some test set and get an accuracy of 88%. I run this piece of code, and using the training set, we get some model and we apply that model on the test set and get 88% accuracy. Remember the reason we split our data into training set and test set, and that's we interested in measuring how well our model generalizes to new or previously unseen data. We are not interested how well our model works for the training set, but rather how well it makes a prediction for the data that has not been observed during training, that is the testing data, how well it performs on the testing data. In this lesson, we will expand on two aspects of this evaluation. We will introduce the cross-validation, a more robust way to assess the generalization performance, and discuss methods to evaluate classification and regression performance that go beyond the default measure of accuracy. And we will provide R2 provide the score by the method. We will also discuss the grid search method, an effective method for adjusting the parameters in supervised methods for best generalization performance. So talking to the first method, which is cross-validation. Cross-validation is a statistical method for evaluating generalization performance that is more stable and thorough than using a split methods in the train and test set. In cross validation, the data is separated repeatedly and multiple models are trained on this data. The most commonly used version of cross validation is k-fold cross validation, where k is a user specified number, usually 5 or 10. When performing five-fold cross-validation, the data is first partitioned into five parts of equal size, which are called as folds. Next, a sequence of model is trained. The first model is trained using the first fold as the test set, and the remaining folds, 2 to 5, they are used as training set. The model is built using the other folds, 2 to 5 folds, and then accuracy is evaluated on the fold one. Another model is split, this time using fold 2 as a test set, and the other data in folds 1, 3, 4, 5, that is treated as test set. So we repeat same process for the other folds as well. So this method is better illustrated using this visualization diagram. So here in this diagram, what we have that we make a 5 splits of the data, and in the first split, the fold one is the testing, another fold 2, 3, 4, 5 are training set. For split 2, fold 2 is the test set, fold 1, 3, 4, 5, they are the used for the training set, and so on. So using the cross validation in scikit-learn, cross validation is implemented in scikit-learn library using the cross-val score function, which is get from the model selection. The parameter for cross-validation function are the model we want to evaluate, the training data and the ground truth labels. Let's evaluate the logistic regression on the IRIS dataset. So from the sklearn model selection, we take the cross validation, and from datasets, we take the real world dataset, that is load IRIS dataset. And then from linear models, we take the logistic regression and apply the logistic regression on the IRIS dataset. And then we compute the cross validation score. And here the first, it is computed the cross validation score for five different splits. For the split one, the performance is 96.7%, 100%, 93%, 96.7%, and 100%. So by default, the cross well score, it performs five-fold cross validation and returns the, their accuracies. We can change this five-fold to 10-fold by changing the parameter CV. So here we are going to change the CV to 10, and now we will get the 10-fold cross validation. So here the sum of the accuracy are 100%, while the other accuracies are 93%. So there is a huge variance in the accuracies. The common way to summarize the cross validation is to get the mean of this data. So we get the mean of 10 values, and then we say that the mean accuracy is 97%. Using cross validation, we can conclude that we expected the model 97% accuracy on average. By looking at all the scores produced by cross validation, we can also conclude that there is a relatively high variance, 93% to 100%. 100% and 93%. This could come up, this could imply that the model is very dependent on the particular data used for the training. When this data is used, the performance is 100%. When this fold is used, the performance is 93%. So performance of the model is data dependent, but it can also just be consequence of small size of the data. So benefits of cross-validation, the benefits, there are several benefits of cross-validation. So instead of using a single split, it's better to use many splits. First, for example, you have train test split and that performs random split of the data. And for example, if you are lucky and you get the all hard examples, hard to classify example in the training set, and then it, the task will be very easy for, it will be very easy to classify on the test set, and the test set performance will be very high. And if you are not lucky enough and all the easy examples, they come up in the training set, and all the hard examples, they are in the test set, then your test set performance will be unrealistically very low. And it will be very low. However, when using cross validation, each data will be in the training set exactly once, and each data will be in the test set exactly once. So the model needs to generalize well to all of the samples in the training set for all of the cross validation score. Having multiple splits of the data also provides some information how sensitive your model is to the selection of training data. For IRIS dataset, we see accuracy is 93.3% and 100%. This is quite a range, and it provides us an idea about how the model might perform in the worst case scenario and the best case scenario. Another benefit of cross validation as compared to using a single split of data is that we use our model more effectively when using train and test split. We usually use 75% of training data and 25% for evaluation. When using five-fold cross validation in each iteration, we can use 4/5 of the data for to fit the model. And when using 10-fold of validation, we use the 90% for training data and 10% for testing the data. And obviously, the more training data, the accuracy will be high. The main disadvantage of cross validation is increased computational cost, as now we're training K models instead of a single model. Cross validation will be roughly K times slower than the doing a single split of the data. It is important to keep in mind that cross validation is not a way to build a model that can we apply to new data. Cross validation does not return a model When calling cross-validation score, multiple models are built internally, but the purpose of cross-validation is only to evaluate how well a given model will generalize when trained on specific data set. And then it comes the leave one out cross-validation. So it is a type cross-validation. Another frequently used cross-validation is leave one out cross-validation. You can think of leave one out cross-validation as a k-fold cross-validation, where each fold is a single sample. For each split, you pick a single data point to be the test set. This can be very time consuming and particularly for the large data set, but sometimes provides good, better estimate on small data set. So here we apply the sklearn model selection, and we see that the number of CV cross validation iterations are 150 and mean accuracy is 97%. And then it comes the shuffle split cross validation. Another very flexible strategy of cross validation is shuffle cross validation. In shuffle cross validation, each split samples training size many points for the training set and test set many points for the test set. The split is repeated n iterations. So next figure illustrates the running of four iterations of splitting the data set for 10 points and training set of 5 points and test set of 2 points. So here have the training set of 5 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2 sets of test points. So shuffle training set. Again, we have the 5 sets of training, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2 for test, and so on. So here is the following code splits the data set into 50% training set and 50% test set for the 10 iteration. So then we apply this and it cross validation and a split cross validation allows for control over the number of iterations independently of training and test set, which can sometimes be helpful. It also allows for using only part of the data in each iteration by providing train size, test size setting that end up to 1. Subsampling the data in this way can be useful for experimenting with large data sets. So this was about the cross validation.